Okay, now it's a bit concerning that you mentioned a while ago that this could have a massive effect, not just on fishermen, but on the livelihood of a lot of your constituents, market vendors you mentioned, even transport groups. This can be overwhelming for the province of Bataan in terms of managing relief efforts and providing assistance. As a relation to that, there are now calls for you to declare a state of calamity. Are you declaring, in fact, a state of calamity anytime soon?
Yeah, of course we declared already a state of calamity last week for Typhoon Carina and Habagat.
Okay.
And yesterday we had a PDRIM council meeting. They've already recommended to the Sangguniang Panlalawigan the declaration of a state of calamity. And I believe this will be taken up on Monday by the Sangguniang Panlalawigan. And I believe it will be approved because of the extent of the effect with our people here in Bataan.
And you have states of calamity one after the other, as you mentioned, one for
Yes.
Carina and another one for the oil spill. Now, in terms of resources, that could be a challenge for the province. Are you getting the commitment from national government for financial assistance as well to augment what you have?
Yes. In fact, for Carina, since we've already declared the state of calamity, Secretary Rec, of course, our regional director has already committed initially 100,000 of food packs, at least for the province. Our municipalities have also given their requests, as well as our congressmen and women. And then we're also working on the emergency cash transfer, and we're looking at helping at least around 60,000 of our constituents.
Okay, and moving forward, learning from the Oriental Mindoro experience, where it took months actually for the provincial government and the city government of Pola to be sustaining a lot of these residents, as the elimination of the oil in those waters may take time. What is your medium to long-term plan for the province?
Well, as usually, whenever we have a calamity, we take turns in terms of providing relief for our constituents. So you have your barangay, you have your municipalities, then you have your province and the region through the national government agencies. And in Oriental Mindoro, when Governor Dolor shared their experience last Monday, in fact, it's really rotating. For week one, it will be this particular LGU. For week two, another LGU, and then the national government comes in. So we will have to try to make ends meet. It will be difficult, but we will try to find a way, as well as get, of course, donations from our private sector partners.
All right, Governor Garcia, I just want to get your take on another news item. This time, the DOJ is saying there could be conspiracy or possible conspiracy in what happened, when you consider the fact that you had three oil spills happening almost all at the same time. What is your take on this? And perhaps, if you have your own investigation, is this a valid claim?
Yes, for Terra Nova, I think we all know, and it's been in the media also, what happened and where they were supposed to go, what were the contents, in this case, industrial fuels. But for the other two, it's more mysterious. And in fact, for Jason Bradley, we reported that July 27 at 2:30 p.m. to the Coast Guard. But until now, we were still waiting for a clearer plan on the salvage operations. The owner haven't met with us yet. We've been asking to meet with them, as well as not only Jason Bradley, but also MV Mirola, which was also mysterious. They both vessels had no
Clearance.
SOS, and
Okay.
then they were abandoned by the crew.
Okay.
So that alone is already a big question mark.
Okay, and will it reach the point, if the owners do not face up or do not own up to what happened, what is your next plan?
Definitely, we will have to look at the legal action that we can pursue. we hope that we can talk to the owner soon, because unlike with Jason Bradley in Merola, Terra Nova, we were able to get in touch quickly with the owners and find out their plans, as well as talk to the salvor companies. But with this other two, it's still a mystery to us up to this point.
All right. Jose Enrique Joyet Garcia, Bataan Governor, again, thank you so much for talking to us this afternoon. We wish you well in your efforts there.
Thank you, Sandy.